a song in my lungs, 'cause I like singing. I like it a lot. It's deeper breathing, it's the reason this mystery will be solved. It's a new day, there's a poem in my lungs, of a freeway to a three-way, if I sing it will be sung, want it will be done, ring it will be.
Strolling around Utrecht looking for a payphone about an hour ago. There are no payphones anymore, interestingly. I do have calling centers now. What?
You have to have a card.
I have a card. I couldn't find a payphone. I'm telling you. I looked for the, I know the little boxes, the little green triangles. You go stand inside the green triangle and you make your call with your little card. I couldn't find the green triangle. I walked all the way around, all the way down to the church, all the way up here. But I found a calling center. This is a really boring story. I don't know what I'm talking about. But the reason that I mention it is because it was lovely. There was people hanging out. They were on boats together, drinking soda pop and eating sandwiches. Drinking a beer down by the canal. That's really sweet. I love this place. I love Europe all together. It's just all a great place. America is a hellhole. I wrote this song about 9/11.
Don't you feel it?
the reason that I am in Utrecht again. This is my new album called Emo. This is the time in the show that I pulled the record out to show it to you. So, and I'm going to play track one. Rolling from your rat sarcastic eye, a California tear drop of gold. Maybe you were cold, so was I. Have to refer to my CD every night. Okay, I'm going to play track number.
Seven.
Shaven. I love the way you say seven.
Shaven.
Shaven. Shaven. Shaven. It's awesome.
Discovered lying next to you. Wish wish I could be.
Say it before I play the song. Then you can kind of... Oh, I'm a little tired, truth be told. I'm fighting. I'm just going to continue to play songs off my record. I'm going to play some old songs. I just don't know which ones to play right yet. You have to help me. Be on the bar boy, right? Yeah, okay, hold on. Let's see. Six.
Sex.
Or is it sex? How do you say it? Sex. Sis. Oh, that's right. Sis. That's really... I was having a five-year-old teach me how to count. I forgot everything that he taught me, other than saving. It's a puzzle that served us well. I think you're funny and you love my smell, but not enough, a lifetime of stuff we could want.
things. Hands on your hip, this didn't miss a thing. You're not mine, though you wear that ring on your finger. One crush had me crawling away. You crush me, brush me aside. But how could I be surprised that in between my shadow and your light, I did lose you. It's been a long year this year. Good or bad, I can't tell from here. But what a thrill, mop up the spell of my heart. There's a puzzle in your angel eyes, a piece we may never find, a piece we may never find at the same time. But in between my shadow and your there's an answer.
It's in between my shadow and your light. Woo!
Number four, fear, right? Fear, it's like German, like Deutsch.
Fear.
Track fear, ready?
Don't be afraid.
Till then, I'll be trying to solve your mystery and wonder why I couldn't make you stay. Thank you. I thought that was a good thing for a while. You gave me all your secrets, were you testing me? And how could I do anything but smile? So reenact your legendary tragedy and do to me what has been done to you. Is that the only point to all this misery? And is there any reason I should cry?
So I must play some old songs now, right? Ugh, dude. Oh, I feel bad. I don't know how to play that song.
Soul on Fire.
I can play that, but you have to switch guitars first.
Healthy Sick.
Healthy Sick. You want to hear Healthy Sick? All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Don't thank me yet. I'm feeling a little loopy, as they say. Loopy. L-O-O-P-Y. Loopy loopy.
No one can stop it all from crashing down to shit. Push to feel something more than just the sound of it. Time, the magic truth of story. Sometimes magic is so very, very boring. It's a healthy kind of sick, a slow sort of quick, a very sad, I don't feel bad at all. It's a different sort of sane, a crazy kind of sane, a feeling without a name that they call. Be true. I watch the dream die every day. I don't know what to do. I know it's only fear that makes me wonder, but I wonder why I'm so afraid. As I wonder why I'm so afraid. I wrote that song before I knew the rules of songwriting. Repeat yourself. It's very clear. I know it now. There's something called a chorus and you repeat it. 2 to 3 times a song. I listened to the reviewers. That's what they said back then. What is this? This isn't a song. Okay. I know. What am I talking about reviewers for? I don't care.
Okay.
Yeah, right. I don't care. Let's see.
The monkey song.
The monkey song. I can do the monkey song. All right. Play the monkey song. Play the kitty song. Now
always a pleasure to play a request off of my new album. Track 8, that was. That was track.
You want track 10?
Track 8. You want track 10?
15!
15! That's a good joke. I like that. There's only 14 songs on the record. Oh, you kill me. Alright. Should I just continue? I don't know why. I usually don't play so many new songs, but they feel all right, right? They sound okay. You seem to like them. All right. My dad likes. It was kind of strange. I wrote it a long time ago, but at the time, I played a few other of my songs for him, and he thought that they all had too many words in them. But he liked this song, so. So I always play it, and I always think about it. Like, why did he like this song so much? That's scary. For coming to see me play today. I really appreciate it. I do say that every night, but I mean it. I remember I had I probably have already mentioned this while being on stage in Utrecht, but I had a terrible show with Sebado here at the Tivoli a few years back, where I gave the audience the finger. Have you heard me talk about this before? I gave the audience the finger, right? Because somebody was giving me a hard time during the show, and I said, "Fuck you," and I gave him the finger, and somebody took a picture of it, and it was on the cover. It was like in the entertainment section of the Utrecht News or whatever, like the next day, and it said in Dutch above it, "Sebado fails to excite." And with me going like this, like, and I thought, like, I'm never going to be able to go back to Utrecht ever again. but since then, I played a show at the, what was it? Ekko? What was it? Ekko. Oh, God. Ekko. That's a sound my baby makes. Ekko. Yeah, so, anyway, I always consider it a personal triumph to set foot on stage in Utrecht. Infatuation, true to
desire, the thrill of discovery, divine intervention, cruel, cruel change, and the pain of rejection.
The song that came right after that on the Seven of Records. Okay. I wonder why I announced that. I don't know.
That you have your doubts, will you always be looking for a way out? And if I convinced you to stay 2 years or 2 days from now, I live in fear of losing you, holding on but trapping you inside. Thank you. is a stupid thing. Don't let it make you stay. Leave me if you're wanting someone else, 'cause I'll be okay. 2 years or 2 days from now, even though I love you more now.
Play a song that is off of a record called Lubicore Volume 1.
Yay.
Yeah. Thanks, man. Thanks a lot. It's funny. The reason that that's funny is because I put out that record. At some point in every indie rock musician's career, we have this idea that we should release our own records. And if you're moderately successful, you get the money to do this at some point. So I decided to do it. And so I made 5,000 of these records that I recorded at home, and I called it Lubicore Volume 1. Did a very simple sleeve for it. And had it distributed and put in stores. And then about 6 months later, I got 3,000 CDs back. In a big box. Actually, there were several boxes. They kept coming, like every week I would get a box. The box of shame. And I tell this story a lot, but it's kind of funny, so I'm gonna tell it to you guys too. When I opened up the box and I pull out the CDs, like each CD actually has the price tag from the store on it. And it would say, so it would say, you know, $15. And then there would be a red slash there. And it would say $12. And then there would be a slash through it. And then it would say like $9. And then they just sent it back to me. So I have so many of these CDs sitting in my house. So I will not be releasing any of my own CDs for a long time. No, it makes you understand how people who do release records, like record people that call themselves record companies and stuff, they lose a lot of money. They really do. I mean, it's really a labor of love that these people go through. And like, you know, but people in bands are always like, God damn it, this asshole releases my records, I didn't get enough posters and blah, blah, blah. It's like, no. It's people that put out records, generally, especially indie rockers like ourselves, or people who are friendly to independent music. We're suckers, basically. we're dreamers.
It's the best you can be.
I know.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. So I'm gonna play a song off that record. And if you feel like it, you can go to my website and buy one. If you'd like it with the price tag still on it, make a note to me, and I'll make sure that you get it.
On the face of my love. I can manage to manage the day. face on the face from above. I am fixed on a screen for my love. 'Cause I can feel what she feels looking fine. Ain't it wonderful, hungry and blind? Did the picture song, track 11. I should know that by now, but it's track 11. The song is called Mary. It is written from the perspective of the biological father of Jesus Christ. Now, I don't know if you knew this. I know I didn't. The Immaculate Conception refers to the conception of Mary and not to the conception of Jesus Christ. Although Mary's parents did have sex, there was a sperm and an egg involved, delivered by a man into a woman to make Mary. With Jesus, this didn't happen. But that's not the Immaculate Conception. Anyway, this song was written by Joseph's brother. Some people really hate this song. Immaculate Conception, yeah, right. Crazy Mary, it's good that you lied. A test tube baby, the seed of the Lord, breaking the law with the man next door. Blame it on an angel, they'll believe. Joseph will wonder, but you know he won't leave. 'Cause they all love you, I still do. There's magic in the air, swirling all around you. Supernova spotlight. They say that he's the one. And brother Joseph got a king for a stepson. Mary, Mary, under the veil of stars. You changed the world, you broke my heart. But thank you, Mary, you saved me too. Let's don't us both. If they ever knew. kissed me and we lost control. The oldest story never told. Crazy Mary, you're forever divine. We'll never know the baby's mine. We'll never know the baby's mine.
Yeah.
Keep her down beside. Last night I set her free. Free to let her spirit climb. Left my choking stare behind. Maybe if her will could grow, she might feel the need to leave. Dying in my shadow. A simple reflection on me. Will I ever set her free? My love, shut her up and break the spirit I don't understand. 'Cause even as we're walking hand in hand, my mind cuts her up. An evil way to build me strong. A sad judge that's so uptight. It's too bad. When I know the answer right, I ask me if I love her as I tell her it's alright. When nothing in my life would fit, I turned into an idiot. Vampire, draining her desire. A vampire, I smothered her with love. When nothing in my life would fit, I turned into an idiot.
I'm gonna play one more new song, okay?
Okay.
I'm telling you what I'm doing. This is what I'm gonna do. This song is for George Bush.
Expect me to ever understand. After all, I'm an ordinary man drawing lines to erase them every day, doing nothing but complain I never get my way. I
friend and agreed to be the proof. Now it's gone, they had it carefully removed. Anything I don't agree with you. Let the babies have their bottle, let the martyr get his due. He'll be drinking till he's angry, picking fights with you. It's never gonna work, cause we act like dogs by eating at the hand that feeds him, pissing on the walls. That was kind of cool. So, but downstairs there were these two girls, and they came up to me and demanded that I sing this song for them. Like, just absolutely, like, you play that song right now. Do it, play it for me right now. Like, and I was like, oh, okay. So, and anyway, the girl's name was Evelie. She's really nice person. And I hung out with her in Utrecht here with my mother. We all slept in the same room together. It was very funny. And afterwards, my mother said, she said, "You're lucky I was there." "You're a married man." But Emily's awesome. I haven't seen her on this trip, but I think about her almost every time I play this song. And then I can't help but think of Holland as well. She took me riding on her bike in Amsterdam. And I guess you guys have this whole way of, like, someone starts riding the bike and then you jump on the back. So she was like, "Do it, it'll be really easy." So I did it the first time and just wiped out, like just sent her flying. And to this day, it's like I still can't. So hard to do. You're very talented people.
Called track 5.
Yeah, it's track 5. Songs don't have names anymore. It's a new age. So many t-shirts to England tomorrow. I have to fly on a plane and I need to sell as many t-shirts as possible. There are only 12. 12 euro. That's not bad.
10!
Look, I'm giving you the Utrecht discount anyway. I usually flog these things for 15. So 12 is a very special price. Shut up, you guys. You shut up. These people don't need to know that. Yes, I sold it for 12 in Amsterdam too. It's true. But only in Amsterdam and Utrecht.
Yeah, right.
9 meg and there were 15. Fuck those guys. I like you. You can come up and inspect it if you'd like. I have them in S, M, L, and XL. Okay. Help. Help me. Pardon. Oh, I designed it myself. Through the miracle of Photoshop. I learned how to use a computer about three years ago, and it changed my life. I learned how to type. I never knew how to do that. I barely graduated from high school.
Where?
Where? Westfield High School. Westfield, Massachusetts. Westfield is west of Springfield. That's why. Springfield is west of Boston.
Simpsons.
Simpsons, yeah. No, the Simpsons are from Springfield, Illinois, I believe. Not Massachusetts. On the banks of the Connecticut River. Okay. In Westfield, they made buggy whips. So in the 1800s, you know, to whip horses, like, whoosh, it was called the Whip City. And in the 1800s, it was a booming city. Booming, like, big business, you know? And then, what's that? No. Like whipping your horse. No, it was all about transportation. No. Giddy up! Yeehaw! But when the automobile happened, no one needed whips anymore, except for sadomasochism. And sadomasochism was extremely underground in 1910, if you can imagine. So I grew up in a dying town called Westfield. Right. Unlike Utrecht, which has been thriving for centuries. Thriving to this day. Amazing. All right. How else may I help you this evening, if you'd like to hear me?
Mystery man.
I'll play rebound first, all right?
Yeah.
As soon as I can hear my guitar. My guitar's off. I guess I have to stop playing. I need to know that. Do I have to explain the theory of performance and what this is about. Okay, anyway. So anyway, I wrote this song when I was really young. And now I'm not so young. But I like these songs. That's why I play them. I like them. It was never my intention to blindly feed the boy-girl game, and I know romance isn't everything, but I'm obsessing just the same. Because today I don't feel Dinosaur.
Yeah.
That's right. You gotta go see his play.
Yeah.
You gotta go, you gotta get tickets for the Paradiso show so we can sell it out. I don't think it has not sold out, so if you at all. It's not even close to selling out. So you should get tickets to the Paradiso and come see Dinosaur play. It's gonna be fun. Okay. All right. Okay. Come and see me scream. Come see a whole different person on stage. I'm gonna have like studded leather wristbands. Leather pants. Tank top with like the British flag on it. You know what I'm talking about? Union Jack tank top. You know what I'm talking about? I don't know what you call those things. The army boots. It's gonna be great. Alright, so I should play a couple more songs and then I should let you guys go make out. Go kiss, go make out near the canal with one of your lovely friends. whatever you do in the springtime, in the beautiful springtime, in the beautiful Utrecht. Okay. Here's a nice song to launch you into the streets tonight.
Spoiled children soon fall. Freedom is a lie we live. We won't wait for tragedy. Scatter helpless to the fire. Sorry for ourselves. And sorry for the things we've seen. Acted outside the strength to turn this game to history. Given up, I'm blown away. She said all I had to say. Final days have come and gone. Safe inside is nothing wrong. Nothing.
No.
Pearl, give it back five.
I'm really just like, so this is all like a huge ego trip for me. Yeah? No, not that one. Can't you think of another one? Come on.
Drag down memory.
It's okay. Let's see. End up playing a song that no one actually requested. Is that okay?
Yeah.
No.
Yes.
Because you requested a lot of songs that I can play, but I just can't. I feel like, in fairness to all of you, I have to choose one that no one actually chose. I don't know if you understand that logic, but. Okay. All right, this is one of them. This, I really like this song. This is a real downer too. Sebado played with the Flaming Lips. We did this big tour with them. It was called the Music Against Brain Degeneration Tour. In which Wayne Coyne had founded on the idea that if you play the Mozart effect, they call it, if you play classical music to a young child, that it actually makes them more intelligent. While we were on the tour, there was a study done, and it was front page news that was actually crap. But there is no Mozart effect. But we soldiered on anyway, on the Music Against Brain Degeneration tour. But Wayne Coyne had never heard the song I'm gonna play, and he was just like mystified by it. He came up to me, he's like, "What is that song about, man? What are you doing? Love is stronger than the truth. What the hell, man? What are you..." Like, he really liked it. So I don't usually drop names on stage. I don't even know why. Why did I mention Wayne Coyne? I don't know. Oh, I know why. I saw Vic Chestnut last night, right? He mentioned Michael Stipe and Bob Mould in one anecdote before a song. I was like, whew. Wow! Double name drop. So, Vic Chestnut was actually quite good. So that's my story about Wayne Coyne, is my tribute to Vic Chestnut.
Try. 'Cause love
Staat hier licht thuis, ik begrijp het waarschijnlijk.